and deployed in different different containers.
So
you
can do that multi container architecture.
Yes, that is actually a microservice. So that concern is that one. Suppose there is a communication between container to container, service to service. If microservice also, we can call API to API, right?
Correct.
So how it will work and how, that is my...
Can we take this offline, Ganesh? Because
no,
let's
no problem.
Not...
nobody is there. That's why I have discussed with you.
Yeah, sure. No problem. See, this is also a good point. So, so you want to like give me your requirement, what you're expecting. So based on that, we can cover this also at the end of the Docker class so that it will be more clear for you as well to implement the scenarios. Okay? Yeah, thank you. So yes, let's get started with Docker. So who is going to share screen today?
Ramesh, you?
I want someone who has Docker installed.
Yes, I have the Docker. I can give you that one. No problem. My credentials and all the things.
It's okay. You can share your screen.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead, Ganesh.
This is the...
Yes. Yeah, we are able to see your screen.
This is the Docker is... I created this one. I 35.
Yeah.
35 is Docker and start.
Go ahead and start it. So last class, we were looking at the port binding, like how to bind the different ports that is related to different applications in Docker, right? So today, let's go ahead and see what is attached and detached mode. Okay. So let me give you a quick definition of what do you mean by attached and detached mode. So whenever we are running the container, we are giving -tt because we want the containers to run in detached mode. That means the control will get back to you once the application starts working. That's what it means, okay? So attached means the application will be running in the foreground. It will not be running in the background, which will be the case of detached mode. So detached mode means we don't want to wait for the application to start loading or start running. We will tell the application to go ahead and start running in the background mode. That is usually called as your detached mode. So let's run a simple container in attached mode so that you will see the exact difference between this foreground and background switching. Okay. So this is done. Let's do one thing. Let's go ahead and run one container. And let's not give, I'm giving you the command. Let's not give the -tt tag. Okay. Yeah, go ahead and update it once, Ganesh. Sudo apt -get update. Yeah, here you give sudo docker also later.
apt-get
space update. Yeah, that's done. Give sudo here. I think it'll ask you for the permission. So now what we are doing is we are starting a container. The container name is attached we are giving, but we have not used -tt, right? That's where you can see that your cursor is still there in the next line, right? And also, it is not returning back your terminal. That means you're not getting that enter where again your Ubuntu at IP, that terminal gets back, right?
Yes.
And also how to see whether this one is running in attached mode. Go ahead and copy the public IP address given the browser as 8080, because we gave that Nginx server should run in 8080. Let's see the application running first. Yes, colon 8080. Enter. So now you see that your application is running. Let's go back to the terminal. So now you see the output here.
Yes.
So this is what happens when you give the containers to run in attached mode. That means you're telling run my application and all the related logs in the foreground so that I can go ahead and see on what port it is running and how the application is performing. Okay, but usually what happens is when we have multiple Docker container scenario, we don't prefer running the Docker container in attached mode. Okay, so to come out of it, you have to press Control C. We are stopping the container. Yes. Okay. And now the terminal is also returning. That's where both the tags, what we saw, like hyphen D and T, D is for detached and T is for terminal, both are understood here, right? So this is the difference between your Docker container running in attached or detached mode. Detached mode means it'll return back your control and also the application keeps on running in the background. Like in case if you want to see the logs of that particular application, you can go ahead and give the command called as docker log and your container name so that it will give you all the logs related to your application. Means your containers. Sudo docker space logs space give attached. Did it give you? Yeah, that's what is the message, right? So these are the logs. That means these are the states that has happened for your particular attached container, right? So this is how you can go ahead and see what is that container doing using your logs command as well. Okay. So now let's go ahead and understand other things about Docker. So whenever you want to start or stop your container, usually it will be docker container stop and the container name or the docker name. Okay, that means your container name. So let's go ahead and see what all containers are running right now. So give docker sudo space docker space ps. Docker space ps, no hyphen, ps directly. Yes. Okay, right now we don't have any dockers running. Give sudo docker ps space hyphen a. So you are seeing few entries. Hyphen a means it includes everything. Okay, so right now you're seeing everything, but the status of that is exited, right? That means all the containers are exited. It's not in running state. So let's create one container which is running. Give different name because I've specified. Oh, sorry. Wait. It did not create, I think. Okay. Yeah. Take this. Okay, so now let's see one more command to list out all the containers. Okay, so this with sudo. So these are the containers that are currently there in your system. Say that means it is 4, right? So there are 4 containers. Let's do one thing. Let's stop one of the container. So in order to stop the container, the command is, I'm just pinging you, it is docker container stop space container name. Okay. But here there is one difference to the commands structure where we have seen, like before we were not using the keyword called as docker container, but here we are giving container also, right? So the next change in docker commands is that you are going to append container keyword in all the commands going forward. Okay, whenever you are doing any operations with respect to container, yeah, sudo docker container stop, give one of the id, give, yeah, anything. Yes, I think that is the one which is running, right?
Yes.
Stop and container id. Okay, it is telling it is stopped. To check, let's run the command sudo docker ps hyphen a. Yes, enter. So now everything is under exited. I think you stopped the same container which was already stopped, is it? Yeah, can we stop the one which is running? About this a minute.
Yes. Exit.
2F6, the container ID which is there in the first one in the list. Yes, that one.
Should I stop this one?
Yes. Sudo docker space container space stop. Yes, enter. Okay, now let's go ahead and check again using sudo docker ps hyphen a, enter. So now you see that all the containers are in exited state, right? So whenever the docker container stops, it doesn't mean that the docker container has been removed. We are just starting and stopping the application. We are not removing the application. Like that means we are not removing the container. In case if it is required later, because see, I don't want to keep all the containers which are in stopped state. It doesn't make like if it is not needed further for my activities. In case if it is needed, then again I would go ahead and start the container giving sudo container sudo docker container start and container id. If it is not used at all again, then I would recommend going and removing the container, right? So in order to remove the container, you have to give docker container space rm and your docker name either or the docker id. Yeah, sudo docker containers, sorry, space rm, yeah, rm space, give the docker id, any docker id. Yes, okay.
Yes,
it got removed, right? So I'm bringing you one command, so that will help you to remove all the containers that are exited or all the containers that are present in your system. Because when you gave docker container ls hyphen aq, it listed out all the containers whether it is running or not running. Because what usually happens is if you are handling multiple containers, you might need to use a bulk operation which might help you to perform operations at one go, right? So that's where this command will be important. Okay. So now let's go ahead and see. This is about stopping your container and also removing your container. What did you do? Okay. I think the command is giving you some error, right? The above sudo docker container rm. Yeah. Because you need to give sudo docker inside that command also. Dollar. After dollar, you have to give sudo inside the braces.
Mm-hmm.
Now go to the same command. Let's edit that command. Click your arrow marks. Yes, wait. So So here, after the dollar, yeah, here before Docker, you give sudo. That is also one command, right? Yeah, sudo space. Yes, now you enter. Yes, now you are getting the result also, right?
Yeah.
Now you should not have anything. Okay. So next, let's go ahead and understand one more functionality of Docker, which is called as Docker EXEC. Okay, this is an important command in Docker because what usually happens is when we start the container, we also want to know how the container is performing, right? We can see the status of the container by using Docker logs, but in case if that also doesn't resolve your issue, then what you need to do is that you have to go inside the container and see what is actually happening. Say, for example, inside the container, maybe some configuration is wrong or some port is not allowed. In that case, your application might be failing. Okay, in the logs, you would not get the in-detail error. You might get the Docker container is not running because of some network issue. How do you go ahead and debug further using this Docker EXEC command? Okay, so let's do one thing. This EXEC is used to run the command inside your running container. Okay, let's do one thing. Let's go ahead and create one container because right now we don't have any container, right? Everything is stopped.
Hello, world.
I'm pinging you one thing. Let's go to engineering. We have the Nginx image. We are going to create a container out of it. Okay, so now let's go ahead and give the command EXEC. So how do you give the command EXEC? Using sudo docker container EXEC space IT, that is for your interactive approach. Docker EXEC is your Docker name that you gave, space bash, because Nginx is having the base library to have your bash scripts. That's where we are giving bash. Okay, enter.
One question here, that how can it recognize that we are that to be interacting with the Nginx?
Because here, Docker EXEC is the name that we gave to run our Nginx image, correct?
Okay.
Right? Yeah, enter. Yes. So now observe one thing carefully. So when you gave enter, it is switching from your Ubuntu at IP something to root at some number, correct? That is your container number. That means right now you're inside your container.
Okay.
Okay, inside your container. If you want to check in details of the logs inside your container, if something goes wrong, you can go ahead and check that. Okay, so let's do one thing. Right now we are inside the container, that means we are inside Nginx and we want to check the status of Nginx. Okay, go to this. Okay, before that, do this thing, because let's go to the bin folders, because bin is a folder which will have all your binaries. Like any application, if you take, bin is a folder where all your application files will be there, correct?
Yes.
So inside the bin, whatever you see, right? No, gives. Don't give that. Give cd/bin. Yeah, cd /bin. Yeah, bin, enter. Give ls. Okay, so these are the binaries. Okay, so inside the bin, whatever you see is all your binaries. Okay, so these are the binaries that you can execute using your EXEC command. Okay, so here if you see, we also have something called as bash, right? So okay, can you clear your screen, Ganesh, because the comment is at the end. Yes. Yeah. Give now ls. Yes. So here you see there is a bash as well, right? The first one, the very first one. The first command is bash.
Yes.
So see, whatever binaries you have, that means these are the executables that you can call using your Docker. Because you remember the command what we entered was docker sudo docker container exec hyphen it docker exec is the name of the container and bash, right? So we selected bash because we wanted to go inside the container and do some operations. In the same way, you can use chown, cp, cat, all these binaries using exec. Okay, based on what is the requirement that you want, you can go ahead and execute all the binaries. So right now, let's do a small thing. Let's go ahead and see the status. So this is not actually okay. I'll give you the command now because that is not ECT, it is ETC. Yeah, go ahead and copy this command. We are now just checking whether this Nginx status is active or not. Enter. So it is telling your Nginx is running, right? These are like your your logging mechanism. If you want to go ahead and check whether that particular application is running or whether you have all the things updated, okay? So go ahead and run this command inside your container because we are already inside the container, right? We are doing is we are installing a small sudo is not found. Sudo is not required because you are already there in the root. We are installing a tool called as NetTools because we want to see some details about network. Okay. Unable to locate package NetTools. Okay. Give netstat hyphen ntlp. Netstat hyphen no space state stat not strt it is net statistics yeah netstat space hyphen ntlp is enter okay
you have to outside the bin
ah that's what give come outside of the bin. Now type in the command to install NetTools, or maybe my command is wrong or what. Or give netstat hyphen ntlp. Let's see though. Okay, it is not able to recognize NetTools. Can you give apt hyphen get install NetTools again?
Update.
Get space install space net hyphen tools. No. Okay, install net hyphen tools. There's no hyphen before net. Yeah, remove that. Yes, enter. Invalid operation. Okay, the install, S-T-A-L-L. Spelling is wrong in that. Unable to locate. Okay. Did you do sudo apt update? You did not do the update, right? Sudo apt get update. I think, yeah, sudo, let's see. Yeah, don't give sudo, just give apt get update. Press above arrow mark, it is also fine. Yeah, now you give apt-get install net-tools. Yes, enter. Yeah, that was because of your update. Okay, netstat space -ntlp. Yes, enter. So now it is giving you some information about your networking for that container, right? So it is telling you what is your port, that is usually your 80 port that is open for your Nginx, right? And it is using the prototype called as TCP. Okay, so these are the information that you can go ahead and see for the application during any of the analysis. So let's come out of this container, type in exit. Yeah, so now you see your Ubuntu back again, right?
One more question I have.
Yes.
Actually, what are the packages are there, inbuilt packages inside the Docker? What is the benefit we are getting from that?
Like Docker packages means, do you mean the command?
You have told me that suppose Hello World or something like that.
Yes, so these are the
images.
Like. Yeah, images. See, the main advantage of having Docker is images only, because if you want to run your custom application, let it be developed by .NET, C#, Java, first what you need is you need to have the operating system in place, right? So that operating system is a base image which is already developed by Docker. You're just using that. That's where you're using the base image from Docker. Upon using the base image, you're customizing your applications. Like if you want to make your custom application to run, then upon the base image, you're running the commands. Without base image, you cannot create a Docker image, or you cannot run a Docker container. That's where images plays an important role in Docker.
Whenever okay. You implement that, you will get that.
Yeah, that's what. Like when you see how to write a Docker file, then you will know without a base image, you cannot write the Docker file. Okay. Yeah, let's go ahead and run this command, give sudo. Don't worry, Ganesh, you'll understand it later. Okay. Yes. So now, okay, so what you gave, you wanted to execute the netstat ntlp outside your machine also. Like instead of going inside the container and running your commands, if you want to see outside also, it is possible using your exec command along with the command that you wanted to see. Okay, so this will also give you which node it is running and what is the type and everything. Okay, so this is how you can go ahead and make use of exec to debug your applications. Okay, so and I hope the importance of IT is also explained, right? So I is to have your standard interactive mode, and also T is for returning back your terminal. Like if you go ahead and execute any command without I, without T separately, you will see the difference. That without I, if you give, it will not ask you for the interactive session. Let's do that here also. So go ahead and type the same command without I. Give only -t. Yes, remove I from the command.
Yes,
yeah.
NTLP,
yes. Enter. This is because we are using already exec, right? Let's do one thing. Let's run a new container. Create a new container here.
So, pull that one?
Yes. Yeah, in one second. Just pinging you the command. Yeah, copy this command. Here, don't give I. Can you remove I here? Oh, it is telling it doesn't remove bash actually. Oh, sorry, wait. No, exec will work only when your container is running, right? So remove one here. Yes. So remove the T here instead of I. Let's check the terminal one. Yeah, remove T, enter. Okay, it is telling that you need both the arguments in order to execute your container. Okay, let's do one thing. Let's create one more container as Docker exec1 and then check that. This is to run your create a container out of the Nginx image, right? And we are naming the container as Docker exec1. Enter. Okay, the container is running. So whenever we want to in order to execute your container, you need -it as compulsory. Like interactive also it should be there, terminal also it should be there. Like if you don't have this combination, then you cannot go inside the exec command. Like exec does not support because it needs both the command to be present together. Okay, let's give instead of -i, remove the -i and give this command, the bash one, the second one in your chat. Yes. This one, remove I. Yes, enter. Okay, so type in something like sudo apt get update. No hyphen for apt. Why it is happening? You press Ctrl Z.
No, arrow key.
Okay. So it is not performing your action because your terminal is not interactive. That means you have given the input. It is not waiting, like you entered something. That means you are giving an input to a command, but it is not taking that input, right? That's where your interactive will come into picture, and you cannot go ahead without giving hyphen I. Okay, Control Z or Control C. Yes. So now give without, give only I, don't give T. Enter. If this happens, that means your control is not getting to the next terminal, right? The terminal is your Ubuntu at IP 1731, that one thing, right? So it is not giving your control back to the terminal. Got it, right?
Yes.
So this is the difference between your hyphen I and T, and you need to make sure that these two combination is present for your exec command. Okay, so press Control Z or Control C. Control C should work. Okay, then let's understand the default container command. So can we see sudo docker ps hyphen a? Because in order to understand the default Docker container command, we need to see the details of the container. Sudo docker ps hyphen a. space hyphen e. Enter. Okay, so we have two containers, exec1 and exec, both are running, right? And here, what all details you are seeing? Container ID, image, command, created, status, ports, and names, right? So what is the command you are having here? Nginx hyphen g daemon off. Okay, so this command, you will understand from where this command is coming. Okay, but later whenever you create your own Docker file and start running it. But for now, you think that this command is the default command with which your container will start executing. Okay, so let's go ahead and see if there are any possibilities to go ahead and change your default command. Got it? To answer your question, yes, we have option to go ahead and override the default container command. Okay? And the default container command will be running with PID 1 whenever you start creating the container out of that image. Okay? But this concept we will see whenever we are creating our own container, so that it will be much more clear. For now, you understand there is something called as command, which will be acting as the default command whenever you start a particular Docker container. Okay, so in order to understand how to override the default command, let's take another example and run a Docker container like this. Go ahead and copy the command. So here, along with the container, we are also passing a command which will override your default command, and this will be replaced with your default command. Enter. Okay, hyphen dt, I think. And name also you need to give. After run hyphen dt space hyphen hyphen name space. Yeah, hyphen hyphen name space test one you give, or test anything. Test space, yeah. Enter. That's fine. Yes, enter. What happened? It is giving you same thing, is it? What is it telling? Sudo docker container. Okay. Don't remove the docker container. Give only docker. CKER docker. Oh, your container spelling is wrong. No, no, still it is wrong. CONTA. N, after N, remove A. Yeah, TA. Yes, now it's right. Enter. Okay. Go ahead and type in sudo docker ps hyphen a to list all the commands. Docker ps hyphen a. So now you see the command of the recently created container is sleep 500, right? So in case if you want to override the default command, you can go ahead and do that as well. Okay, hit the command again. Enter.
Not this one.
Sudo docker ps hyphen a. Yes, enter. Okay, it is still running, is it? So after 15 seconds, what it should see, do, it should go to sleep, right? That's what is the overriding command we gave. That means it should ideally, let's not give 500 seconds. 500 seconds means it will take some time to execute and then stop, right? So go ahead and click on the command. Let's change it to sleep 5 so that we can see after the sleep 5 default command, it will exit. Okay, but you need to change the name of the container. Give test 1. Yes, enter. Yeah, now enter Docker PS hyphen A. Yes, enter. So now it is up running. Yeah, enter again. Is it showing you exited?
Yes.
Because after 5 seconds, it is exited out of the container. That's what was the default command what we gave. Right? So this is how, in case going forward, like when you start writing your own Docker files and managing the containers, if you want to know if there is a possibility to override the default command, yes, you can do it. And how? This is how you can go ahead and do it. Okay? So this is about your default container command. Next, we are going to understand about restart policies. Okay? So why restart policies will be important is because, say for example, you have around 10 Docker containers running in the Ubuntu machine, right? So that is your Docker host. Say for example, for some reason, your Docker host stops and restarts. Okay, maybe that is a security update, or maybe due to network issues or any kind of maintenance activity, your server will restart. But what happens to the containers which is already present in the Docker host? It will all be stopped, right? So what you will have to do, again, you have to go ahead and start it. But there is something called as restart policies in Docker, which will help you to restart your Docker containers automatically when there is a restart or when there is a error like this, okay? So for that, we are going to use a restart policies flag. Let's see how does that work. Okay, so that your Docker container should automatically restart whenever there is a restart of your Docker host, or if the Docker exits due to some issues, it should automatically restart based on your restart policies. Okay, so before seeing the scenario, in order to do your restart policies, you have a restart flag, and for that restart flag, you have 4 options. Okay, the default restart policy is no. That means it will not automatically restart your container. Okay, the other options are on failure. Like whenever there is an error in a container, do you want to restart the container again? That is for your on failure. There is the most widely used option for restart policies is unless stopped. That means what happens? Mostly we will be using this because restart the container whenever it is not explicitly, whenever it is explicitly stopped, right? So in case if your Docker host only restarts, or if your Docker itself restarts, do you want to start your Docker container automatically? That's where your unless stop, like unless you go and stop it, if something else happens, it should start automatically, right? And there is the last option, which is called as always. That means whenever your Docker container stops, restart. Whether it is you who is stopping that container or whether by the system it is getting stopped, it should always keep on auto starting. Okay, so these are the 4 options. Let's see one of the options. So for that, let's go ahead and create a container. Hyphen hyphen restart is the flag name. You can give name also for this, like we don't have a name, right? Hyphen DT you give. And also hyphen hyphen name is give test 2. No, hyphen hyphen name space test 2. Space test 2. Okay. Yes. So what is the restart policy? Unless stopped, right? Enter. So now your Docker container is running. So let's go ahead and stop or restart your Docker. Okay. Yes, it is running. Go ahead and type in this command. Give sudo docker restart.
Vista Docker or Docker?
Sudo Docker, sorry, sudo restart Docker, I think. Just check the command. Maybe it should be a little reverse. Huh. Sudo Docker restart. Give your container ID, sudo docker restart space your container ID of the first one, test2, right? Yeah, give that. Yeah, now you give sudo docker ps -a. Okay, so we just stopped the container, right? But still, you're able to see that it is up for 7 seconds and it just started, right? But it should not, yeah, it should not give you up 7 seconds. That means you did not restart the container. Okay, give me a second. Give docker space restart space hyphen hyphen help. Just want to see the syntax. Okay, container. Okay, when you gave the container, it gave you that it stopped, right? Okay, let's do one thing. Let's stop it. Okay, sudo docker stop and the container ID. Okay, now you give sudo docker ps -a. Yeah, it exited, is it? Yeah, give again. Yeah, give again sudo docker ps -a. Okay, because unless stopped means like we are only stopping it, right? That's why it is not restarting. Okay, in case if your docker system restarts, it would start automatically. Okay, let's do one thing. Go to the system, like go to your docker machine and give stop and start. No, instances. This is your docker hub. This is like your repository kind of thing. Yeah, go to instances. Yeah, here, stop it and start it. Okay, you have done the update, right? So let's go ahead and check sudo docker ps-a. Mm,